The DeskProto CAM software makes it easy to create, to use your CNC milling machine to create wooden inlays like these works of art in wood, where you use two colors of wood to show an image or a text. So a light colored wood plug inserted into a dark wood base. And DeskProto makes it easy to create these two parts. Here you see it, the base and the plug, and obviously they need to exactly fit together, and DeskProto can help you achieve that. The toolpath type that I will use in this video is V-carving, and first I'll take some time to explain why. Because why not use simple 2D toolpath in pocketing? Here you see a design, the base in dark wood with a pocket, a five-pointed star machined in the wood. And here in the light wood, you can see the plug to be inserted. Well, the problem with 2D toolpath, with standard 2D toolpath, is that, of course, you cannot machine sharp inner corners. And in this design, both in the base and in the plug, a number of sharp inner corners is present. So when you machine this base, the result won't be this five-pointed star. It will look like this. And obviously, that is not what we want. So the solution is to use V-carving, as when I use V-carving toolpath, the result will be like this. Here the sharp inner corners are present, and they're achieved using an upward sloping toolpath made by the V-shaped cutter, the V-bit, to the top surface of the material block. Second advantage of using V-carving is that these sloped surfaces, both on the in the base and on the plug, make the assembly a self-centering process. Simple, press them together and automatically the optimal position will be achieved. Okay, V-carving and inlay. To start with, you need a 2D drawing of your design. Here the drawing that I used in the example. In this video, I won't explain how to create a 2D drawing. In the previous video about V-carving, I already showed how you can use a drawing like this in Inkscape. However, you can, of course, use any vector CAD program that you like. Okay, so let me switch to the computer screen and start DeskProto. Here we are, DeskProto version 8, and I want to use the entry edition. V-carving is available in all three paid editions, but not in the free edition. So for this tutorial, the entry edition is fine. I need to start a vector project, as for V-carving and inlays, you need a vector project. My file, SVG file, is on the desktop. Here it is. It's simply the word CNC and a frame around. This is in Times New Roman. I want to tell you, you need to check the build date of your DeskProto. Your DeskProto needs to have a build date of 2025 or later, as the first few versions of DeskProto 8 contained a few errors in the V-carving algorithm. So please check and update if needed. Second thing to check is the machine, which is one of the project parameter settings. Here we are. This is the machine that you have set as your default machine when installing DeskProto. So in most cases, it will be okay. For us, it is okay as well. So no need to change that. And then the only settings to be done are in the part and the vector operation. For the part, I will make the settings for the base. So I will call this part base. And in fact, the only setting is the block size. X and Y are already correct. This is the block that I have, only it's a bit thicker, 20 millimeter thick. So these are the part settings. No curves have been selected. That's correct. We haven't yet done that. that needs to be done in the vector operation parameters. I call this one V curve, this operation. And the first thing I need to do is select the V bit, as otherwise V carving is not possible, obviously. In DeskProto, these are listed as conical cutters. I use a cutter with a 45 degree side angle, so 90 degrees included angle. Feed rate and spindle speed, well, the best values depend on your machine, on the capabilities of your machine, so I can't give general guidelines, only say that the defaults in DeskProto in most cases are okay for your machine, as the defaults are set per machine. Z settings, my grooves may not be deeper than 4 millimeters, then they will be topped off or bottomed off by a flat surface. When deeper, no profiling, no pocketing, V carving, and here I need to select curves, as I do not want this outside curve to be included, only the three characters C and C. Okay, that's it. And the final thing is roughing. This is a bit light machine, so sinking into the material 3 millimeters at one time is a bit much, so I go in layers of 2 millimeters each. When I press OK, you'll see that the selected cutters are in darker gray. This is not relevant, it will work fine. Okay, so I can now simply calculate toolpath. Here we are. I'll close this one, and here you can see the two layers, minus 2 and minus 4. Here a bit of a flat bottom in the resulting part, and the simulation will show, calculate what it will look like. This is the base, and the grooves will be filled with a lighter wood that will create in the plug. So the final step is to write the toolpath file, write and C file, and I'd call it base. Yes, the file extension is .nc. File extension differs per machine, so the file extension that you see should be the extension for your machine. To keep the video a bit varied, I will now first go to the CNC milling machine to create the base, to machine the base. After that, I will return to DeskProto in order to create toolpath for the plug. Back at my PC, where the DeskProto project still is open. Now the toolpath for the plug. I'll simply copy the part base, obviously call the new part plug, and then we need to change the settings. Well, the most important setting is about the design transform, because in order to make the plug fit into the base, we need to mirror the design, as otherwise they won't fit. I will mirror by inverting the x-axis, as you will see here. Now we have a mirror image. And I want to make one more change in the material, as for the plug, the block needs not be as large as for the base. I have a bit smaller block, 110 times 40. It needs to be a bit larger than the design. Okay, here we are. And in the operation parameters, I also need to change one thing, and that is the curve selection. For the base, we just selected these three curves, and the inside of the curve has been removed. For the plug, we need to add this curve, and then the area in between both curves will be cleaned and removed. So instead of a custom selection, I'll select all curves, apply. So this one has been selected as well. Okay. Now I can again calculate toolpath, and again this will take some time here, as this complete area will be filled with toolpath. Here we are. So this is our design, and let me check that in the simulation, and all seems okay. Here we have the same three characters, however now standing up the material instead of being pockets. Unfortunately though, this result is not okay. I will explain why and also show how to fix this. And to do so, I'll use this very simple example, inlay with a simple square in the center of the block. Here is the base, machined a pocket with sharp inner corners. You see the V shape in the block. And when I use exactly the same process as just described, this will be the plug. And to make it a bit more better visible, I halved it. I used half the block, and I look at it from the front view. Well, here is the plug and the base. And when I flip the plug, you will immediately see that the base and the plug do not fit. The plug is far too large, as the image was on the top surface of the base. So the base is correct, the plug is too large. We need to make the plug a bit smaller so that it will exactly fit in the pocket, in the base. I want to keep a bit of room in the center below the plug. I want to keep 1 millimeter space there for the excess of glue, and also for the remaining material there, as the V-bit that we use cannot machine a completely flat surface here. So some material cusp will be remaining. So 1 millimeter there. The pocket that I machined was 4 millimeter deep, and the plug also was 4 millimeter high. So there will also be a second gap will be remaining here between the two blocks, and that's the gap that can be used to saw off the remainder of the plug, as we will see later. So we have two gaps, and here this then is the level of the curve, of the design curve. And when we flip the block, we see that the curve should be located at a depth of 3 millimeters in order to make the plug fit into the hole, into the base. Back to the PC, where I need to change, let me hide this one, the settings of the V carving in the operation parameters for V carving. And here you can see an extra setting, you may already have seen it, the curve depth. And that's the one we need to use, as we just explained, -3 in this project will be okay. Yes, and again a calculation that will take some time because of those large areas that need to be covered with toolpaths. Here we are. Well, here you can't see what we need, so I make a simulation. Here we are, and this result, those characters will exactly fit in the holes, in the grooves that we made in the base. You can even see the flat bottom of the grooves in the base. So this is the one that we want to machine, and I can save an NC program file for this operation, and I will call it plug and bring that to the milling machine. So now we have a base and a plug that nicely fit together, exactly fit. I no longer have the original parts as we have already processed them, but I can show you the process that we followed. First, both the base and the plug need to be completely covered with a wood glue. And after that, the two parts can be tightly clamped together, and overnight they will be strongly attached to one another. The next step, the next day, was to remove the remainder of the plug using our bandsaw. And when you don't have a bandsaw, or when it's not large enough, you can of course use your CNC milling machine to completely remove the remainder of the plug, though then you will use a smaller block of wood for the plug, obviously. And here is the result that we achieved. It's a beautiful inlay of the character CNC, light wood in dark wood. Well, a very nice result. Obviously, we can say much more about how you can make this process a bit more efficient. For instance, by also using a flat cutter to clean up the flat bottoms, and to use an offset curve in order to reduce the number of toolpaths with the weak bit. However, the process as shown in this video is a valid process, and it provides a very simple way to create great results like this one. Okay, see you later in the next video. Thank you.